squish.
This is 2011 Volvo C70. We're gonna change out the radio. I already got the radio out. I'm gonna show you how the radio comes out. You pry this plastic bezel out. Carefully pop this out. Top section first, because there is a clip on the bottom that hooks up like this. So once you pry this top section, you can lift this one up. Once you have this plastic bezel out, this display has come out. You start it from this cutout corner right here on the bottom and pry this out, and this display comes out. And then you can disconnect this. There's a fiber optic cable here along with other copper wires. We're gonna disconnect that. So there is a locking clip. You just push the tab and it pulls out. Now, once you disconnect this, a lot of things not gonna work, such as power window, power door lock. So we're gonna re-enable these fiber optic cable. Otherwise the window door lock may not work. Once you have these out, the two torx screws here, we're gonna remove them. So once you remove that, this woodgrain detaches. Next step is there are two torx screws on the armrest for the back. Remove those two torx screws there. Okay, so after you remove these two screws for the back, you gently pry that out and this woodgrain comes out. So after you disconnect this plug, you can remove that panel. So this panel, it goes out that way toward to the driver's side. There's a clip here. You're gonna remove that. So under this armrest, there's a panel that's AUX plug. Remove that. Underneath, there are two torx screws. Remove those two. All right, it was very difficult to figure this one out to be removed. So there was a first screw right here. It's no big deal. Yeah, you can just reach down here. This one on the passenger side screw is easy to come out from here. However, this one is directly under here. So what you do is put a screwdriver here, wedge in and pull away from this e-brake, and you should be able to get to the screw right on the driver's side. So once you have these two screws out, just remove that. That was a mission. So even though we did remove these screws here on the armrest, we didn't have to. We just simply remove the side panel. This panel by the e-brake, it's wedged in this way. So you gotta push the clips here to release, then it goes towards that way. You can access this screw here, driver side, wedge screwdriver against this e-brake, push away from it and release that screw. This one you don't have to, you can just do it through here. Then remove this green plug from the wood grain, put it in D or somewhere in the back. Then you lift it up like this and pull out. So there are two torx screws. We're gonna remove this. We're gonna put new radio in it. So there are clips on the bottom of the radio panel. You're gonna have to release that. I'll show you where that is. So these locking clips mounted on the bottom of the radio, that kind of hits the panel, this frame right here. So you're gonna have to undo this little locking pad right here. There's a fiber optic, be careful not to break it. All right, this guy is an amplifier, it's a fiber optic, obviously we're gonna have to disconnect that. This is driver side in the trunk. You can access this corner right here. You just remove this panel here. There are a couple clips here. You can move this away. The amplifier is actually right down here. In order to take this out, there are 4 8 mils. You can take it out. Either way, you can just reach. There's a cutout here. And you can actually put your finger all the way down, push these release tabs right here, unplug it, and there's a cutout right down there, and pull that plug out. It has enough slack, so you can actually pull this out, and we're gonna use a 9-conductor wire, run this wire all the way up to the radio for the speakers. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna cut these off, so I can put the face through this hole without, the Metra said cut this off, I don't wanna cut that. So rather, I'm gonna cut these inner pieces, and this face goes through this . So we ran 9-conductor wire from the back by the amplifier in the back. I'll show you online what color is what. And this doesn't have a ignition here, but does have a constant. The red yellow one is the constant, but the ignition is not there, so we're going to run the ignition wire from the fuse box. This is actually a cigarette lighter here, right behind the gear shift knob. That's an ignition. That's the 12 volt. We're going to use that for the radio power.
Sunday is where?
Sunday and noon, it'll be mostly sunny with a high of 48 and a low of 31. On your steering wheel, fast.